In the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. This morning, I figure we have living proof that the internet, for all its flaws, functions as a tool of the divine. I mean, what are the chances of these two unique individuals finding one another? They're Catherine living in East Baltimore, Pris living beside a lake in Westfield, Massachusetts. But the internet can only open the door to relationship. Pris and M.C., with the support of this loving community, have done that work of forging and maintaining a relationship over the past 11 years. Was it clear at all that this was a match made in heaven? Indeed, one might know that their household is a place of some tension. You see, M.C. is a wannabe hoarder. Her things have a way of creeping through the house like moths in a rainforest. Pris, on the other hand, is quite neat. She dislikes clutter and delights in clear surfaces. And C likes cats. Pris likes dogs. Their compromise is a wild menagerie of two dogs and four cats. MC's ahead. MC likes to play with computers. Pris gives them a wide berth. MC likes precision and numbers. Pris, not so much. I could go on, and so probably could many of you. The question then is, what has bound them together all these years? Why, despite their differences and the places from which they hail, are they still together, eager to make a covenant with one another, echoing the pledge of Ruth to Naomi? Where I go, where you go, I will go. Where you lodge, I will lodge. Your people shall be my people, your God, my God. I think the answer to that question of why lies in the reading, the gospel reading you just heard. I know that it's unusual to hear the story of the Good Samaritan read at a wedding. This may be the first time. But then, these two are not an ordinary couple. They are not just two people in love. In love. They are two people who do love. They don't just think love, say love, have faith in love, or believe that God is love. They act love. Let's look at the Samaritan again. He comes near the wounded man, the stranger. He sees him clearly, is moved by him, bandages his wounds, puts the man on his animal, brings him to an inn, takes care of him, takes money from his pocket, asks the innkeeper to take care of the half-dead man, saying he will come back and repay whatever more the innkeeper spends. Now, in Hebrew, that's a whopping 14 verbs in that one sentence. In that Samaritan, God's word becomes flesh. What finally binds Pris and MC together is service, is love of the neighbor. They are love in action. like the Samaritan at the beginning of the story, they never hesitate to come near. Near enough to feel, near enough to recognize a neighbor in someone who needs a neighbor bad. Separately and together, they have taught us all, everyone in this room, by consistently modeling love in action. Can you imagine how many verbs they're going to generate as a legally married couple? Today, they are giving us another great gift. The gift of saying finally and truly yes to each other and to God and to life. It's time, ladies. Are you ready? Amen. Please come forward.
No, it's the anthem.
Okay. I was all eager to marry
out.